Good evening. You're watching the news from the Sultanate of Oman Television. First, the headlines. His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, receives a cable of greetings on the occasion of the Armed Forces Day. After an overseas voyage to India, Shabab Oman 2 returns to the homeland. And France extends the climate summit for another day after efforts are stalled to conclude a global agreement on climate change. Those were the headlines. Now for the news in detail. His Majesty Sultan Qaboos sent a cable of greetings to His Excellency President Uhuru Kenyatta of Kenya on the occasion of his country's independence anniversary. His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, has received a cable of greetings from His Excellency Syed Badr bin Saud bin Hareb al-Busaidi, Minister responsible for Defense Affairs, on the occasion of Armed Forces Day. The cable said, in an atmosphere of happiness, progress, glory, pride, construction, achievements, future aspirations, Sultan's Armed Forces are celebrating its glorious golden day, recording glories and sincere steps. He said he is honored, along with victorious Armed Forces, Firak Forces and all affiliates of the ministry, to forward greetings and best wishes on this dear occasion, requesting Almighty to bestow on His Majesty health and happiness. The cable added, the 11th of December is a truly shining mark in the history of Sultan's Armed Forces, that peace was spread all over Oman, preserved dignified life and enlightened bright future for its citizens. The country became peaceful and prevailed with harmony during His Majesty's reign. The Armed Forces celebrate this glorious day as inspired by His Majesty with sacrifice and sincerity under the leadership and thought for brighter future and prosperous living on the peaceful homeland. Along the years of the blessed Renaissance, human resources of Sultan's Armed Forces attained care and attention which made it in line with cultural and knowledge development at the scientific and military level. They became a national wealth, active with responsibility in all sides. Today, the Armed Forces, with trained and qualified manpower potentials, became civilized and balanced interactive forces with other government institutions through bridges of cooperation and integrity. With principles of comprehensive development, looked forward towards better future, giving at the same time pivotal attention for raising up fighting capabilities and complementing the necessary arming system in line with the requirements of the stage, conforming with renewed challenges to be always a deterrent force, protecting the homeland and its achievements. The cable added that Armed Forces will remain abiding by its developing role in the society, inspired by wise directives, happy with His Majesty's praise for its role in performing the sacred duty of preserving the homeland and its achievements, renewing loyalty and obedience to His Majesty's wise leadership. His Excellency Syed Badr bin Saud bin Hareb al-Busaidi, Minister responsible for Defense Affairs, concluding by praying to Almighty to preserve His Majesty as a leader for Oman, endow His Majesty with long life and good health. The Sultanate celebrated today the Armed Forces Day, which falls on 11th of December. The Sultan's armed forces have accomplished a number of achievements in various organizational, training and armed aspects, thanks to the royal generous attention and care accorded by His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces. The armed forces are taking wide strides towards construction and development in line with the requirements of each stage, performing their sacred national duty of protecting the soil of the homeland and preserving its gains and achievements effectively, raising up fighting capabilities and providing an integrated necessary arming system in accordance with current stage requirements were the focus of the armed forces development until it became a deterrent force, preserving the homeland and its achievements, as well as the Omani values and human resources, were the aim of all plans for whom the achievements of the Renaissance will be transcended with dedication and sincerity for the homeland and the Sultan. The ship Shabab Oman II returned to the country after ending its second international voyage to India. A reception ceremony was held when the ship docked at Port Sultan Qaboos in Muscat under the auspices of Rear Admiral Abdullah bin Khamis Al Raisi, Commander of the Royal Navy of Oman. The ship participated while in India in the celebration of the 60th anniversary of inaugurating the Indian Embassy in the Sultanate. This voyage showcases the depth of cooperation and well-connected relations between the two countries. Shabab Oman II came to shed light on the Omani-rich maritime history and the modern achievements in the Sultanate. The Ministry of Manpower celebrated the graduation of a new batch of students in the Technology College in Musana. The ceremony included the graduation of 579 male and female students in six specializations of bachelor and diploma degrees. The ceremony was presided over by His Excellency Said bin Hamed Al Rubai, Secretary General of Education Council. The graduates expressed their happiness for graduation after the hard work and efforts they exerted during the years of study, as well as their pride to join the work field to serve the country. Still to come in our news bulletin, the third Journalistic Reporters Forum was concluded in the wilaya of Sohar. Welcome back to the news from the Sultanate of Oman Television. The French hosts of UN talks said today that envoys tasked with staving off catastrophic climate change are on track to seal a historic accord. The 195-nation conference in Paris had been scheduled to wrap up today, but was extended for another day after ministers failed to bridge deep divides during a second consecutive all-night round of negotiations. Still, Foreign Minister Laurent Fabian, who is presiding over the talks, voiced confidence that the event would culminate with a much-awaited pact. World leaders have billed the Paris talks as the last chance to avert disastrous climate change, increasingly severe drought, floods and storms, as well as rising seas that would engulf islands and populated coasts. the outcome of a laborious two-decade-long process, the post-2020 Accord would commit to all nations to curb greenhouse gases that trap solar heat, warming Earth's surface and disrupting its delicate climate system. Several big polluters, such as China and India, as well as Saudi Arabia, prefer a ceiling of 2 degrees Celsius, which would allow them to burn fossil fuels for longer. A spokesman for the Syrian Kurdish YPG militia said the death toll from a triple truck bomb attack in a town northeastern Syria had risen to 60 people, with more than 80 others wounded. One of the blasts occurred outside a hospital, another at a market, and the third in a residential area in the YPG control town of Tel Tamer. A statement on the website of Kurdish security force blamed the attack on the Daesh. The town is located in the mostly Kurdish-controlled province of Hasaka. President Recep Tayyip Erdogan has said Turkish troops deployed in Iraq for training purposes in fight against Daesh were not on combat mission and their pullout was out of the question. The deployment of several hundred troops by Turkey in Bashika, close to an area held by Daesh in northern Iraq, has enraged Baghdad, which has asked Ankara to withdraw all its forces. Turkey has a long-running training program at a base near the city of Mosul, Daesh group's main hub in Iraq, but the deployment last week expanded Ankara's presence there. Erdogan's comments came a day after he met with Iraqi Kurdish leader Masoud Barzani, who has long-standing ties with the ruling Justice and Development Party government. Erdogan said Turkey, the United States and Northern Iraq will hold a trilateral meeting on December the 21st to discuss all issues. North and South Korea sat down to rare high-level talks today aimed at building on an August agreement to ease cross-border tensions after a flare-up brought them to the brink of an armed conflict. Previous efforts to establish a regular dialogue have tended to falter after an initial meeting reflecting decades of animosity and mistrust between the two countries that have remained technically at war since the end of 1950-1953 Korean conflict. The last such sit-down took place nearly 2 years ago. The meeting was held on the North Korean side of the border in the jointly run Kaesong Industrial Zone, which opened in 2004 and has survived as a rare symbol of inter-Korean cooperation. Dunes by Al Nada, a luxury dessert resort, said the enigmatic golden sands of Wadi Al Abiyat in the wilayah of Nakhal marked the official launch of the property under the patronage of His Excellency Ahmed bin Nasser Al Mahrazi, Minister of Tourism. More details with Saif bin Khalfan Al Kindi in the following report.
Dunes by Al Nahda in the wilayah of Nakhal, with its exotic location, premium facilities, and fine dining offering 50 ultra luxury tents, each with full in-suite individual bathrooms, separate seating area, bringing together luxury and simplicity in a classy and true five-star way. His Excellency, the Minister of Tourism, and the guest toured the resort and expressed their happiness of the project. Niti Ajit Kersandans Hamilai, Managing Director of Al Nahda Hotels and Resorts, the parents' company of Dunes by Al Nahda, pointed out that Dunes is all set to offer an experience of a lifetime. Niti said,
"Here you learn a lot of culture about Oman. You learn how to make shua. So when you go as a tourist to Italy, you learn about pizzas, how to make. Everybody doesn't want to do quad biking alone. So we have, of course, quad biking, going for camel rides. But for the entire family, our USP is that we have something for everybody to do. There is an activity area where people, children and parents can make castles. So if they copy Nizwa Fort, for example, very nicely. We give them a lunch here, give them a meal.
Located in Wadi Al-Abyad, a 75-minute drive from Muscat International Airport, Junis Bayanada recently received the prestigious title of Preferred LVX Property, a member of Preferred Hotels and Resort. His Excellency Mohammed bin Sulaiman Al-Kindi, member of Shura Council in the Wilaya of Nakhal, pointed out.
This resort will be one of the exciting places in our wilayat, in Nakhal. So so many people, so many visitors coming to here. They wanted to get a relaxing time and a good time with their families here. And we hope to find these good points here in this resort.
I'm very pleased to announce that we have a management training program in which even Omanis are participating, and they will grow to the next level to become managers in any of our properties. So they are going through a 12-month vigorous training.
The resort mainly is a promising project for the tourism sector in the Sultanate and expected to attract many visitors.
The integration of Dunes Resort in the Wilaya of Nakhal will increase the visitors and the tourists to these areas and present the natural features of these landscapes. Saif Al-Kindi for English News, Nakhal.
The Craft Industries Forum in the Wilaya of Ibri in the Governorate of Dahira came to encourage female students to enter this field as well as to acquaint members of the society with a traditional heritage. It witnessed a great participation from members of the society, including men, women and school students. During the forum, women showcased their products that included handicrafts, bags, baskets, keychains and clothes. The forum also witnessed children shows and poetic sessions. The third Journalistic Reporters Forum was concluded in the Wilaya of Sohar. It was organized by the Omani Journalists Association and presided by His Excellency Sheikh Mehana bin Saif Al-Lamki, Governor of North Batina. The three-day discussions resulted in numerous recommendations centered on overcoming obstacles that are faced by journalistic reporters to enable them to make coverages, as well as to establish a club for journalists, provide proper training and legislation for the profession. Citizens in the village of Al-Abyad in the Wilaya of Nakhal held a ceremony to celebrate the 45th Glorious National Day. It witnessed a huge participation from members of the society, including men, women and children. It included various activities, namely traditional dances accompanied by Omani singing arts and national poems. Poems were recited praising His Majesty the Sultan and the achievements realized during His Majesty's glorious reign at all the levels and walks of life. During the ceremony, the participants expressed their love and loyalty to the leader of the country, His Majesty Sultan Qaboos. The ceremony came to stress on the joy of the citizens on this glorious occasion, as well as the march of the blessed Renaissance and the achievements accomplished by the Sultanate during the last 45 years. Rejoicing the 45th Glorious National Day, citizens in the Wilaya of Buraimi organized a ceremony on this occasion. It was accompanied by poetic sessions and traditional dances, where the citizens and poets expressed joy and love for the country and its leader. The ceremony witnessed a participation from all segments of the society, who prayed to Almighty Allah to protect His Majesty as the guardian of this country and its people. It also included a section for traditional Omani food as well as heritage products. Now for the general weather forecast, clear skies will prevail over the Sultanate with chances of scattered clouds and dust over the coastal areas of the Sea of Oman and the governorates of Musandam and South Sharkia. Winds will be northerly to northeasterly light to moderate, occasionally active in the coastal areas. Seas will be rough with a maximum wave height of 3 meters. This is the Sultanate of Oman Television. Before we end tonight's bulletin, here are the main points once again. His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, receives a cable of greetings on the occasion of the Armed Forces Day. After an overseas voyage to India, Shabab Oman II returns to the homeland. And France extends the climate summit for another day after efforts are stalled to conclude a global agreement on climate change. With that, we come to the end of tonight's news bulletin. From all of us here at the newsroom and the studios, it's good night.